A typical radiator core support is a pretty straightforward structure, but not in LokJaw. Ours has to support all the usual equipment plus two custom big-ass ram air intake housings. Remember that phrase about putting 10 pounds in a 5-pound bag? Well, this is it.
Binks Built, protected by AMSOIL, with support from Roadster Shop and Nitto.
Not looking too bad there. Then we've got the low temperature radiator, which is more or less just a thinner version of the engine radiator, a little bit smaller. Yeah, we might just bias it off to the side here. In front of this guy will be our condenser. We'll be able to... Yep. Okay, so it's parts day here for LokJaw. Today we got in a lot of important stuff for the cooling package. We've got our radiator, our low temperature radiator for the charger cooling system, and our condenser. So what I'm gonna do now is kind of get it in place, mocked up, get an idea of what kind of bracketry we're gonna need, if anything needs to be cut, modified, which I can already tell by looking at the LTR, we might need to do our own fittings. But that's what I'm gonna do here. So I'm gonna get them all mocked up, go a condenser, LTR, then engine radiator, and see what I can squeeze in here and where to go from there. For the top side, it's got this nice lip, which I'll probably just end up doing a through hole and doing a rubber isolator with a stud on either side. Bracket off this bottom flange here. This should be a pretty straightforward fabrication process. Giving your bracket a run for its money, you know? One bend, one hole, a square.
We're still riding on the high from getting that hood on.
Hold on, you're almost in.
Oh wow, that's like really smooth.
So we took it back off because we got to mount more of our cooling package in the front. We've heard Gail talk about what we're gonna do up here. We gotta make that reality. So we got a couple parts. We got the radiator already in and mounted. This other heat exchanger is part of our supercharger system. In the manifold, we have a charge air cooler known as a CAC. And we, in the front of the radiator, we have a low temperature radiator or LTR. So we're gonna mount this LTR and we're gonna mount our air conditioning condenser. That's gonna be the very next thing. And we're gonna stack them in this order. Radiator, LTR, condenser. We get a very small amount of heat rise through the AC condenser and good AC performance if it sits all the way in front. If we swap that in the low temperature radiator, we get a large heat rise through the low temperature radiator and our air conditioning doesn't perform as well. So we're gonna take a little bit of hit on the air temperature going through the low temperature radiator for the supercharger system in order to be nice and chilly in our cab. Okay, we'll come across like right here or something. And just come up, maybe we'll tab and slot that.
Mm-hmm.
You dig?
Yeah, in that case, it might just be easier to do those out of steel, 12 gauge or 14 gauge.
Yep, make it all out of steel. You wanna put a bend in this one? You wanna bend it all? Or do you wanna tab and slot this piece?
I think we could bend it.
Yeah.
It'll be a cleaner look for something that might be seen. Anything that you wanna draw up in CAD and engrave onto something.
Now, cut to finished bracket. We measured for our brackets for our low temperature radiator And for our AC condenser out on the truck, I've got them here sitting next to me. Drew them up in the computer to the core support. These on either side will pick up the low temperature radiator. And then sitting in front of that, we'll pick up the AC condenser. We'll send these over to the torch mate, blast them out on there, bend them up on the finger brake, and put them on the truck.
Montage to finish bracket. No, I gotta do it.
And we have brackets. Now we're ready to bolt on the heat exchangers, LTR, and AC condenser. Brackets are all done. That was fast. Now we're good. Bolt them up. All right, so one of the big things that I've got to figure out on this truck is how we're going to do the air box through the radiator core support on each side and get ram air into this thing like Gail discussed when we were talking about the whole supercharger intake system a couple of weeks ago.
So is that our new headlight location now that we're running dual headlights?
So this right now is representing our ram air location, where we are going to poke through headlight number two in our 60 Chevy truck grill in our 66 C20. Kicks back to Gail's heritage at the lakes and running ram air through the headlight in his duty back in the day.
Breaking the record and getting outlawed the next year. Yeah. So you know you're doing something right.
So here's what's going on right now. So in red is our air filter, and it breaks through the plane of the radiator core support. So we have to seal off airflow from passing by that so we catch the ram effect, and we still pass air through our radiator so we cool the engine and our condenser and our charge air cooler. So we're trying to direct all the airflow here.
And still make it serviceable and, you know, being able to
and be able to get the filter in and out without a
cutting off
doing metal. Something ridiculous. And the biggest things I learned as a mechanic is that some engineers really suck.
Are those starters hidden in the transmission mm-hmm. bell housing?
So I'm trying not to do that.
Yeah.
And we're gonna make this so you can pull this filter out. You pull the tube off and you can pull the filter out and we can service it. Because we're gonna put miles on this truck. So the other thing I wanted to do, you can see when we look down on the filter here, we've got our ram air entry point here. I kind of did a scroll design on this. So we're gonna bring the air in. We're gonna have a little shield right here, like Gail talked about, to keep rain from ingesting directly into the engine.
Right.
And we'll use the momentum of the air to fling anything to the outside, and we'll wrap around this scroll. It's essentially a scroll here that we've created, and into the filter.
That's so cool.
Yeah. I gotta make some transition from this round up into the air box here.
Right, which we could probably even 3D print to.
Yeah, we may end up 3D printing that and getting that in place so that Sean can do all his work. And then we'll get big old 5-inch air tubes coming into our massive supercharger inlet.
So, I say we make this thing out of mild steel and let it rust. Match the core support.
As long as you get your tetanus shot, right?
Yeah. Hey,
that's going to be a prerequisite for getting into LokJaw. Yeah, so I'm close to done with this thing. A couple more hours in it and I'll be finished. And then you get to make it.
That's the fun part.
That's the fun part. So a little more work to do. Coming along. We're getting there.
Chipping away. Chipping away.
look over here, what we've got laid out on the ground is our airbox kit. So we are gonna turn all of this flat sheet metal into this. So this piece here is gonna sit up against the core support, and right through our headlight and our 60 Chevy truck grill, we're gonna bring ram air in. The fun stuff.
How about any non-compound curves?
Well, it's all...
It's all compound.
No. It's all non-compound curves. So the slip roll, one piece is a constant radius, so that one's probably gonna be the easiest, but the other pieces are variable radius, but non-compound curves. So
good, not
easy,
great.
But hard.
Yeah.
So we'll see what happens. Did this in a cave
with a box of scraps.
The airbox is mostly done right now, but we've got holes in it. Yeah, I mean, that's looking pretty good. What do you think?
That is the most protected filter that has ever existed. Let's put a train horn on the front.
Yeah.
That'll be the velocity.
Yeah,
stack.
We'll get a big old bellows on here.
I'm telling you right now, you gotta fire your blacksmith.
Get back here! I'll bite your kneecaps!
Oh, man. All right, guys. I am back after a much needed week of rest. As you can see here, we've got the core support and the air boxes back. So Sean's got so much on his plate with LokJaw and other projects that I'm gonna help him out, and I'm gonna finish up what we should have done. And so these overlays, I'm gonna go ahead and cut out the rest of the parts on the torch mate for the overlays. And then once those are in, I can go ahead and cut out the holes of the air boxes and splice those in. And that's one thing less for Sean to do. So I got some cutting to do. We didn't really have a great reference for going up and down. So now that I've got the cut piece in here, I've noticed that we landed a little low on the holes that we drilled out. So you can see them just kind of poking through there. So that means what I need to end up doing is I'm gonna pull this off, I'm gonna patch those two holes and end up re-drilling this out. And depending, it looks like there's a doubler in these, so I might even end up going with the square nuts on the backside. It's gonna be tough to weld, so I'm thinking I'll run a square nut and that can bottom up against this top surface to keep it from rotating. Now that I have the holes plugged up from the bad through holes, I was thinking through my order of operations for this guy, and the air box is gonna poke through and actually come in and occupy some space, which is why we went through and redrew this shape. Instead of welding these on and trying to go back and cut out that shape, I'm gonna go ahead and cut out this shape first. Okay, quick check-in. I've got the two main air box sections cut out. So what I'm doing now is I've got my cutting jig back on here and I've got to splice out this little section here. And once that guy is gone, I can go in and fine tune this rough cut. And I'm ultimately gonna take the air box and get it to lay in. And once it lays in, I can come in with my new overlays. So I've got the upper overlay here. And I've got the two lower overlays, and I'll end up tacking those, probably stitch welding those in, and then throw in the new bolt holes, and then we can actually go and bolt up the airbox and give it back to Sean. Airbox is in place. All right guys, air boxes are finally in. I am really happy with this fitment. It turned out to be a lot of filing, fine tuning. Took me a lot longer than I would have wanted, but I'm very happy with how they turned out. You can see the cut lines, just how tight that gap is. It's close enough to where I think I'm gonna have to go back once these are welded up and even trim it some more. But I've got the engine side overlays tacked in here, so you can see that's gonna be our new shape. It kind of keeps that straight line and tapers off. And at the bottom, we've kind of got that cut out to incorporate our 5-inch tube. So I got to take another look at the CAD and see how these are going to incorporate into the rest of what Sean's doing. I'm hoping that we can send it back as is, but I might have to go in and tack in the front side and just leave the overlays until afterwards. But yeah, super happy with how this turned out. It's a little bit heavier, but man, that looks sweet.
Wait till you see the new sheet metal. Sean at Empire Fab has been making metal magic. We'll check in with him and then we'll get to work on our new digital dashboard. It's all in the next episode.